Statistics is used in everyday life in a number of situations, and you don't even realize it. When you wake up in the morning and you check out your cell phone to look at the weather, those predictions are based on statistics. When you go to the supermarket and you use a credit card to make a transaction, whether the transaction is approved or denied is based on statistics. So one of the really cool ways we use statistics at LinkedIn is to identify which members on the site are looking for a job. Once we're able to determine that a member is looking for a job, we're able to cater the content on the site to that need. We're also able to use this information when hiring managers and recruiters are looking for candidates. And that's just one of the many applications of statistics. When I first started learning statistics, I wish somebody had told me that it was such a team sport, that it was very important to work with other folks in the team to make sure that your data was correct, to learn how to train models the right way, to understand that it was very unlikely that I was going to get it right the first time, and I had to work with other people to iterate on these models and eventually get it right. Statistics is amazing because it has many diverse applications, from search results on Google or Bing, to movie recommendations on Netflix, to recommendations on what you should be shopping for on Amazon, to social media recommendations on LinkedIn and Facebook on who you should be connecting with. We are producing so much data these days. Regardless of the field that you pursue, whether it is astronomy, criminal justice, or medicine, going forward, you've got to know statistics.